subscribe Tag TV YouTube channel and press the notification button.
You're watching Tag TV.
India is known around the world for its history, cultural heritage, and diversity. Its ancient scriptures and texts have been the way of life of its people for thousands of years. Today, the country is taking huge strides in various fields like arts and science, paving a way towards a progressive India. So friends, I'm your host Shreyasa Vijay, and today in our episode of My India, we'll take a look at some of the stories that very well showcase the unique culture and prosperity of our country, stretching from Himalayas to Kanyakumari. Art exhibitions play an important role in portraying the emotions of artists, along with providing them a platform to showcase their exuberant skills. Organized on a periodic basis across different parts of the country, these exhibitions provide a wonderful opportunity to people to know about the rich heritage and culture of a particular state or region. So today, let's take you to the recently held Art and Craft Festival in the hill town of Shimla that saw a display of magnificent artworks from across the state.
The hustle and bustle in Shimla unfolded as it hosted the 5-day-long Art and Craft Fest at the Reach, located in the heart of the city. Showcasing the rich culture and heritage of Himachal Pradesh, the fest was organized by State's Language, Art and Culture Department. Artists from various districts of the state like Kangra, Chamba, Kinnaur, Mandi, Shimla and Kullu participated in the event to showcase and sell their artworks to visitors who came from different parts of the country.
मैं ये पाइन नीडल से बनाती हूँ जो बेस्ट इज रॉ मटेरियल पाइन नीडल में फॉरेस्ट में गिरा हुआ होता है उसका अच्छे से यूटिलाइज करती हूँ उन्हें वॉश करती हूँ देन इसका यूज करके उसके प्रोडक्ट्स बनाती हूँ जैसे मैट्स हो गए ईयरिंग्स हो गए बास्केट्स चपाती बॉक्स स्टूल्स मैट्स और काफ़ी कुछ और बना सकते हैं
Varieties of handicrafts were showcased during the fest, including beautifully carved bamboo artworks, metal craft, pine products, shawls, footwear and paintings. The event even provided a great platform for the tourists to access the entire state of Himachal Pradesh at a single place, along with leaving them spoiled for choice.
बहुत बढ़िया और मुझे तो लग रहा है कि हर चीज़ यहाँ से एक एक करके तो उठा के लेके जाना बहुत ही ज़रूरी है क्योंकि इतना अच्छा कल्चर एकदम ही मतलब हिमाचल पूरा ही हम लोगों को ऐसा दिख रहा है कि छोटी सी जगह पे ही सारा इकट्ठे ही हो गया है तो बहुत बढ़िया मैं तो आई एम थैंकफुल टू हिमाचल गवर्नमेंट कि उन्होंने ऐसी चीज़ ऑर्गेनाइज करी हम जैसे लोगों के लिए जो इतना नहीं ट्रैवल कर पाते तो एक ही बारी में हमको सारा वेरी ब्यूटिफुली डन
The fest was organized keeping in mind all the guidelines and COVID-19 norms issued by the government and served as a great opportunity to provide business to the artisans who were sitting idle for months due to the pandemic.
ये जो अभी कोरोना का चला हुआ था तो हमारे यहाँ के जो लोग थे उनको बहुत ही मुश्किल हो गया था तो इसको देखते हुए हमने इसका आयोजन किया दूसरा आजकल एक जैसे फेस्टिवल का सीजन चला हुआ है तो बाहर के लोग काफ़ी आ रहे हैं तो वो उनको देख के भी बहुत अच्छा लग रहा है जो हमने यहाँ का अरेंजमेंट किया हुआ है उसको भी सभी बहुत सराहना कर रहे हैं कि हर चीज़ का ध्यान रखा गया है इसमें, तो अच्छा मतलब खरीद भी रहे हैं वो और इसको देख के खुश भी हो रहे हैं।
Indian culture is full of beautiful artworks depicting the heritage and history of the nation. Events like these enable us to embrace our beautiful culture and allow us to spread and share the artistry imbibed in our nation.
India is a land of religious diversity where people of all faiths have been living peacefully since ages. Mutual tolerance and regards for each other's beliefs is an age-old tradition of the country. Several examples of citizens who are trying to preserve it can be found at every nook and corner of the country. The Muslim flower garland makers who have been carrying out their business in Udhampur district of Jammu and Kashmir for the last 25 years is one among them. Have a look.
Making and selling of flower garlands near the road is not a big thing. But it becomes unique when a person is making it specially to be used by other religious community. Setting such an example of communal harmony is a Muslim family residing in Katra area of Riasi district who, for the last 25 years, has been growing flowers and weaving garlands to be used by their Hindu brethren. They mostly sell these garlands in and around Udhampur district and prefer to sit beside a temple so that devotees who come to pay their obeisance do not face any problem in getting a flower garland.
लगभग 25 साल से मैं और हमारे खानदान से पहले भी ये फूल का काम करते हैं। उधमपुर में भी, कटरा में भी और जम्मू में भी करते हैं। तो सर ये फूल का एक ऐसा पवित्र काम है, ये मतलब मंदिरों में या हर अच्छे काम के लिए इसको इस्तेमाल किया जाता है। हर एक काम की शोभा बढ़ाने के लिए, इसको बाज़ारों को, दुकानों को, घरों को सजाने के लिए, तो सर हमें ये काम करके एक बड़ी खुशी होती है।
These garland makers have huge respect for the beliefs of Hindus and feel happy to sell their products to them. They make these garlands with lot of hard work and dedication and wait eagerly for Hindu festivals when their business of flower garlands shoots up. The locals too feel overwhelmed to see them carrying such a respect for the sentiments of other community.
इन्होंने छोटा सा एक टोकरे से शुरू किया था। और कहने का मतलब ये है कि इनमें जब बात करो इनमें कोई वैसी बात नहीं नज़र आती कि ये मुसलमान है, और इतना ये हमसे बढ़ चढ़ के त्यौहार मनाते हैं। कोई भी त्यौहार हो, यानी कि दिवाली है, कुछ भी, ईद हो, चाहे गुरुपुरब हो, कुछ भी हो, हम लोग सारे इन पर निर्भर हैं और इनमें कोई ऐसी बात नहीं। मार्केट वाले आते हैं, कोई 10 हार उठाता है, कोई 5 उठाता है, और ये कभी किसी से झगड़ा मैंने नहीं करते हुए देखा इनको। इससे एक मैसेज आता है कि हम सब एक हैं।
Such examples prove that Indians put unity on the highest pedestal and stand undivided and integrated despite all the cultural and religious differences.
Now, a roundup of some of the major stories that made news recently.
Hindu devotees in Uttar Pradesh recently celebrated the Govardhan Puja festival with devotion and fervor, a day after Diwali, the festival of lights. Celebrated to worship Lord Krishna, devotees in the temple town of Varanasi prepared and offered 56 types of special food to Krishna in a bid to impress the Lord on the auspicious occasion and danced, sang and prayed for happiness and prosperity.
गोवर्धन पूजा में हम लोग भगवान के आगे नृत्य करते हैं, वो हलवा का पहाड़ बना करके और उसमें गोवर्धन जी का हम लोग बनाते हैं तस्वीर और उसमें फिर आसपास सजाते हैं और छपनों भोग चढ़ाते हैं और छपनों भोग चढ़ा करके हम लोग नृत्य करते हैं, गाते हैं, नाचते हैं, कीर्तन होता है, भजन होता है और उसके बाद से हम लोग प्रसाद ग्रहण करते हैं सभी लोग मिलजुल करके।
Meanwhile, in holy town of Mathura, devotees met hillock symbolizing Govardhan mountain, which was then decorated with flowers and worshipped by the people. The devotees also moved in a circle around the hillock and offered prayers. Legends say Lord Krishna dissuaded the people of Gokul from worshipping the rain god Lord Indra at the end of every monsoon season. This angered Indra, who brought about a rainstorm to frighten the people, but Lord Krishna lifted the whole of Govardhan mountain for 7 days and saved the people from the wrath of Indra. Humbled, Indra then became a devotee of Krishna. Devotees lit 584,572 earthen lamps in northern temple town of Ayodhya that Hindus believe to be the birthplace of Lord Ram, a day ahead of the festival of lights Diwali, and reportedly set a world record. The 3-kilometer-long bank of Saryu River in the holy town glistened when all the lamps were lit by devotees. Adding to its shine was a laser show, which showed various facets of Ramayana, a Hindu epic. Legends say millions of lamps were lit when Lord Ram returned after 14 years. Lighting earthen lamps signify welcoming Ram to Ayodhya and victory of good over evil. Mural artists in Rajkot city of Gujarat came together to showcase their talent at an exhibition representing the culture and tradition of the country through art. About 70 Rangoli murals depicting Hindu deities, health workers, politicians, film actors and human faces among others were made by the participants. Every year, hundreds of artists used to participate in the exhibition, but with the pandemic this year, only 35 artists participated.
काफी लोग आ रहे हैं, उन्हें मेरा पोर्ट्रेट अच्छा भी लग रहा है, तो मुझे भी काफी अच्छा लग रहा है कि लोग आके मेरी सराहना कर रहे हैं और रंगोली उन्हें अच्छी भी लग रही है.
More than being an art form, Rangoli making holds special significance on religious Hindu occasions. Women, especially in southern and western India, make colorful murals during festivals, prayer rituals, and weddings. The murals are usually made in temples and at the entrance or in the courtyard of the house. Devotees thronged the holy Sikh shrine, the Golden Temple in Amritsar city of Punjab, to celebrate Bandi Chhor Divas, that is Day of Liberation. Hundreds of devotees were seen offering prayers and enjoying fireworks that lit up the sky.
God se prarthna karte hain ki next year bhi aaye. एंड कोविड-19 की वजह से पैंडमिक की वजह से थोड़ा इस बार कम संगत आई है एंड गॉड के प्रे करते हैं कि नेक्स्ट ईयर तक ये प्रॉब्लम सारी खत्म हो जाए.
बंदी छोर दिवस सेलिब्रेट्स द रिलीज ऑफ 52 प्रिंसेस इम्प्रिजन्ड बाय मुगल एम्परर जहांगीर इन अक्टूबर 1619 बाय सिक्स्थ गुरु हरगोबिंद. आफ्टर द रिलीज, Guru Har Gobind arrived in Amritsar in the midst of Diwali. Since then, the day has been associated with the liberation.
India is a country where Sufism has not just flourished but has also become a way of integrating different religious communities. Even today, the teachings of these saints inform the lives of people, and this was very well reflected during the special prayers held at the shrine of Saint Hazrat Tawakkal Mastan in Bengaluru, where people of all faiths assembled to seek the blessings of the holy saint.
The shrine of Sufi saint Hazrat Tawakkal Mastan Shah Sehrwardi has served as a synagogue of communal harmony for generations. It is thronged by a large number of devotees every day from across the nation, irrespective of their religion. Regarded as an integral part of heritage walks in Bengaluru, the Dargah of Hazrat Tawakkal Mastan brings to light the messages of Sufism and peace which were propagated by the saint. Devotees of all religious communities attend prayers and ceremonies organized at this Dargah to offer their prayers to the Sufi saint.
I'm basically an Hindu, so yeah, my wife was not feeling well. I mean, we came to the hospital over there, and she's the one who suggested to come to this place, and she told, like, once we do this, like, puja and all, I mean, the child, whatever, she's also, like, in the midtime, she gets, you know, some kind, she gets up automatically, and she feels uncomfortable. So we thought to come here and do kind of a puja, and so she would feel comfortable, and she would feel better.
Regarded as one of the oldest and largest, the shrine is standing in the bustling lane of Cottonpet area in Bengaluru city for the last 250 years. Equally popular among citizens of the Hindu community, the Dargah has a number of folklores associated with it. A popular one says that the Sufi saint was trampled during a Hindu Karga procession and was revived by a Hindu priest. Thereafter, all processions during the Karga festival stop at the Dargah for devotees to offer their prayers to the saint. The Dargah, therefore, is thronged by Hindu devotees all around the year.
साल में एक बार करगा होता है, बेंगलुरु करगा, तो हमारे आदमी लोग से ज़्यादा गैर कौम इधर पे आके, हिंदू लोग आके बाबा के पास पूजा करके, और जैसे करगा होता है बाबा के पास ही आके पूजा करके ही जाते हैं। तो इसमें क्या लगता है कि हिंदू मुसलमान का एक यूनिटी रहता है, लेकिन आज तक जो भी है बाबा के पास जो भी आके मुराद मांगा है, तो हिंदू है या मुसलमान हो, कोई भी हो, कोई खाली हाथ नहीं गया, सबका काम हुआ है और बाबा सबके लिए फैज करते हैं।
कमिंग फ्रॉम फार एंड वाइड, दीज डेवोटीज अटेंडेड द प्रेयर्स टू सीक द ब्लेसिंग्स ऑफ होली सेंट। इट इज बिलीव्ड दैट सेंट फुलफिल्स द विशेस ऑफ ऑल एंड नोबडी रिटर्न्स एम्प्टी हैंडेड फ्रॉम हियर। Since ages, the Sufi saints like Tawakkal Mastan have propagated the message of spiritualism and harmony in our country, and their teachings are still playing a significant role in strengthening the threat of secularism.
Kashmir is truly a year-round travel destination. All its seasons, be it summer or winter, have their allure that beckons travelers from India and abroad. During this time, autumn season is at its peak and tourists are flocking the valley in large numbers to enjoy its new look of the landscape covered under a golden blanket of dazzling chinar leaves, which is a feast for the eyes. Have a look.
The tourism activities are slowly picking up pace in the Valley of Paradise amid COVID-19, as the yellow, crimson and golden hue of autumn is offering a mesmerizing beauty to the tourists. The season is regarded as the most beautiful among all the seasons, as the maple leaves of majestic Chinar trees turn from green to gold, offering a complete mystical look. During this time, tourists mostly prefer to visit Mughal gardens such as Nishchat, Shalimar, where they get to see this majestic scene.
ऑटम सीज़न तीसरा सीज़न है यहाँ पे, तो इसमें अब फेनेल की तरफ जाते हैं, अप्रोचिंग विंटर सीज़न होता है, तो इस ग्रैंड एक ग्रैंड फिनेल आता है इन द शेप ऑफ जो कलर चेंज होती है, तो ये जो ग्रीन लीव्स होते हैं, ये ग्रीन लीव्स कन्वर्ट हो जाते हैं ब्यूटीफुल गोल्डन कलर में चेंज हो जाते हैं, तो ऑल ऑफ अ सडन जो है वो जो लैंडस्केप है हमारा नेचुरल लैंडस्केप वो चेंज हो जाता है, तो खूबसूरती बढ़ जाती है गार्डन्स में।
Chinar that dots the autumn landscape of Kashmir has also been described as Aatishe Chinar, that is the Chinar on fire by the famous Urdu poet Allama Iqbal. They also share a number of amazing facts with the Kashmir region. Some say that chinars were brought to Kashmir from Iran. Others say they have come from Greece. The world's oldest and biggest chinar tree, which is 627 years old, is found at a garden of a Muslim shrine in central Kashmir. According to renowned environmentalist Muhammad Sultan Wadu, the tree was planted by a Sufi saint, Sayyid Abul Qasim Shah Hamdani, in a garden at Chattergam in 1374 AD. Today, the shedding of these chinar trees, locally known as Buin, attracts a number of tourists who come to see its glorious beauty in autumn.
This is my first visit to Kashmir. My first time Kashmir I am, and I came specifically during the autumn season. Why? Because I heard it's really beautiful here, and I could see, like you guys can see, we have this beautiful chinar, and the color during the autumn is like wonderful. So I would like to tell everybody, you know, they should come to Kashmir and promote its tourism. And of course, it is one of the most beautiful city in India. We call it heaven on earth, and it's a reason you guys can see it why. And मैं अभी कोविड के दौरान आई हूँ, and I was like not facing any kind of issue. Everything is as perfect as it could be.
During the autumn season, the people of Kashmir also start collecting leaves of chinar and burn them in a pile to make coal for their kangri, a traditional fire pot which helped them in braving the harsh winters. Thus, besides serving as a major draw for the tourists, the chinar leaves also help the locals to fight the chilling cold conditions.
That's all we have for you this week. Your comments and suggestions are important to us. Do give us your feedback at mindia@nin.com. I'm your host Shreya Savijay, and it's goodbye from the entire production team.